can explode at any minute.
Oh,
and
a big right hand
landed by Martin Nguyen.
Really cuffed him, didn't he? Got a clean shot in there. By far the biggest step up for Christian Lee is what Martin Nguyen represents. And Christian got back in with a left hand there that also caught his opponent fairly cleanly. So a good punch each from these men in the opening seconds.
That overhand right is real dangerous for Nguyen because Christian kind of keeps his posture really high and his head looks like it's really elevated, so he doesn't kind of tuck the chin in. So he's susceptible to that overhand right from Martin Nguyen.
It's Lee very much in pursuit mode, as we thought it might be.
Nice catch there on the kick, spins around, takes control, and this is where Martin Nguyen wants to get this fight. He wants to make it dirty, wants to make it gritty, and he likes to drag these fights down to the ground. Trying to single leg break takedown, but Christian pops right back up.
He did so well to land on his feet there. Looked for a moment as if he'd be landing on his head.
Very
athleticism
agile.
And flexibility, agility, that's right, exactly the word we were looking for.
There's another one of those big right hands coming from Nguyen, but Christian ducks under it. We have ourselves a fight, folks.
What an arc to that uppercut from Nguyen, which I'm not sure that it connected, but sent out a message, didn't it?
When I saw this fight on the card, I knew that this one could be the Fun 88 fight of the night.
What a decent overhand right that was from Nguyen as Lee came in.
He's thrown out a stiff jab there. He's got an awkward guard. You know, he keeps a very wide guard, very wide stance. Not your typical boxing stance or Muay Thai stance.
Good left jab from Lee there, but it's that counter overhand right from Nguyen that he's got to be careful of when he throws that jab.
Nice. I like how he threw that overhand right, stepped forward with the right foot, and then came with a left overhand.
And Lee's been quite adept just in the last 20 seconds of getting out of the way. But he caught that one. And bounce straight back up again.
That's it, man. Christian's got to get his chin down. His head's really high in the air, and Nguyen is taking advantage of that with these big overhands.
Can't take your eyes off this one for a second. Good ramrod left jab from Christian Lee.
Now Christian's starting to get a little bit more compact in his stance. Again, another overhand right,
kick.
Steve.
Yeah, he threw the kick. It was exposed to the right hand, wasn't he? These counters from Nguyen are expert punches.
Will we see Christian Lee in the second round? And that's the question on everybody's mind.
The energy, the sharpness of youth, very apparent from Lee, but you can just see that little bit more seniority from Nguyen. A little bit more cleanliness to his work.
Well, he's timing these overhands perfectly. Christian's got to keep that chin tucked. Not let him get caught by one of these big overhand rights, or lefts for that matter.
Christian Lee hasn't seen an opponent like this in the ONE Championship game, so that was a good right hand, and it set Nguyen stumbling it, and Nguyen's in trouble.
And Lee just wobbles up.
Nguyen pounces on this. This could be his opportunity. Gets in close, that head is exposed to possible knees. Lee bounces back up, but he goes back down again. He's certainly shaken up.
Christian's hurt, Steve. Big left hook landed by Nguyen, started this onslaught, and Nguyen is jumping all over it.
Could already be the Fun 88 fight of the night, this one. You just cannot take your eyes off it.
He's kind of got him in a guillotine here, sort of a modified choke.
Oh, it looks very clean as well.
He's kind of lacing his hand around
under
his
chin. I'm not sure how he's getting through this.
Christian's fighting, he might be out.
Jadambaa, so much strength, so much power. If he puts Martin Nguyen on his back, Jadambaa's got those meat hooks, those massive anvils of fists that can rain down punches in the ground and pound.
Like how Nguyen opened up with that lower leg kick. Start the movement of Jadambaa. Jadambaa likes to plant that lead leg and then start throwing wide angled shots. He doesn't really throw a lot of linear punches. throws a lot of hooks, a lot of uppercuts, a lot of overhand rights. And I like how Nguyen's immediately starting to attack that lower leg because Jadambaa can't plant off that lead leg.
Look out for the overhand right of Martin Nguyen. It's the bread and butter punch. May I say bread and vitriol punch of the Australian. He used it to win the featherweight title from the seemingly unstoppable Marin Gafarov. And then he used it to knock out Eduard Folayang to win the World Lightweight Championship. And he timed it, thread it to the forehead of Jadambaa tonight. Long-reaching jab from the champion. Jadambaa, the former world champion. Swings low to Nguyen. Nguyen says he's never trained as hard as he did over in Florida with Henry Hooft and Ong Ma and TL Tang. Front kick there from the champion. Jadambaa, who's been itching, who's been waiting for this opportunity, this chance to get back into contention, to get another tilt at the strap. He wants more around that muscular waist.
Martin's starting to touch Jadambaa very slowly, very methodically. He's starting to see what's landing, what's not. But what now, what's landing right now is that lower leg kick. He's hit him a few times in the head, and that hand is, that left hand of Jadambaa is slowly starting to drop. And I think Martin sees it just like I do, and he's gonna start to throw that overhand right.
Jab from Nguyen. Just seeing, as Mitch said, what Jadambaa has to offer. Overhand right there from the former world champion. Drift back to center circle. Jab again from Nguyen. High kick from Nguyen.
Jadambaa's also being very cautious. He's not being reckless at all. He's slowly inching forward. Just, he's also thrown out that jab, which is not something he loves to throw.
Tucks that roundhouse kick under the left arm of Jadambaa. Jadambaa just massive traps and a huge back and enormous deltoids of the Mongolian. Roundhouse kick there from Nguyen. Front kick from the Aussie. Jadambaa threads the jab to the right hand. Had the power, didn't have the distance, nor the timing. Nguyen being very careful, methodically selecting each strike. Not overexerting himself. Not leaving himself open to a counter. He's got tremendous respect for the former world champion from Mongolia. But as Mitch said earlier, the team believes they've found a chink in the armor of Narantungalag Jadambaa.
And see, when Martin steps forward, he plants his left foot. That's when Jadambaa is throwing his leg kicks. And you can see it. When the difference between the two, Martin's throwing his leg kicks and Jadambaa's kind of riding them. But when Martin steps forward, that's when Jadambaa's landing and the full weight of that leg kick is impacting Martin's leg.
A beautiful Brazilian kick there from Martin Nguyen. Otherwise known as a question mark kick. Fakes downstairs low, then arcs over the top for the head of the opponent. Jadambaa, a little tentative here, Mitch, in the first round, for your liking.
That leg kick, though, that lower leg kick, it's because all the weight is on Martin's leg when he's starting to throw it. You can start to see him shuffle a little bit. I don't think Martin liked that last leg kick. Jadambaa's being a little tentative, yes. He's not throwing forward, but he's picking him apart. He's throwing that jab out there. Jadambaa's an experienced striker. He's had over 29 kickboxing matches against some of the greats, so he knows what he's doing in this situation.
Jadambaa used to compete at the highest level in kickboxing. He was a K1 Max competitor. Took on the best of the best. Left hook there from Jadambaa. Final 10 seconds. Left hook from Nguyen. Nicely done from the champion. Jadambaa goes downstairs, kicks the chin. We are going to go into the second. The former champion tonight, the challenger, Jadambaa Narantungalag. Seeing what Jadambaa has to offer again, Martin Nguyen. Very cerebral performance so far from the Vietnamese Aussie. Front kick from Jadambaa. Roundhouse kick to the liver there from Nguyen. One of two Nguyens on tonight's card. Earlier on, we saw reality TV star B. Nguyen make a successful one championship debut, who win over Nguyen Retno Wulan of Indonesia. Good body shot there, tipping to the belly button from Nguyen. Overhand right, the money shot of Martin Nguyen. Goes downstairs, you see.
Ooh, that one hurts Jadambaa.
Jadambaa, Jadambaa's left leg is hurt. And Nguyen's going on.
So used to throwing. He relied on it every single one of his matches so far. But is it his only weapon? I can't wait to see him unveil new dimensions in his game.
And how will Nguyen handle the power of Eduard Folayang? If Folayang touches him with that right hand, how will Nguyen stand up to it? You can bet that Nguyen's never been hit in competition by someone of the strength and size of Eduard Folayang. Jab from the champ.
Folayang is just hurling those tree trunk-sized legs at Nguyen's body, attacking the legs, attacking the midsection, and eventually he's gonna go after the head.
Fari Selievsky in the corner of Nguyen, a very cerebral camp. They said they worked on speed. They know they've got the disadvantage in weight. The advantage in speed, they believe, makes up for that shortfall. And still a filling out contest with 2 minutes down in the opening round. Martin cuts off the cage. Folayang not overextending, being very cautious here. He knows the capability in the overhand right of Martin Nguyen. Cutting side kick to the lead thigh from Folayang. Nguyen cuts off the cage again. Controlling the center, flying on the outside. Spinning back kick there from Nguyen. Oh, spinning heel kick from Folayang. And that hits a muscle behind it.
Folayang didn't really adjust his stance. He still has that probing left hand that's circling down by his hip, waiting to come out with that jab. And Martin Nguyen's known for that right hand of his where it comes over the top. You think Folayang would like to keep his hand a little bit closer to his chin, just like he's doing right now. As Martin Nguyen approaches that boxing distance, look for Folayang to keep his hand a little bit closer to his chin to protect that big right hand.
Nguyen gauging his distance with the left to set for the right. That's the power hand of Martin Nguyen. Big slinging outside leg kick from Folayang. Sell our crowd inside this massive arena, all on the edge of their seats here. And firmly behind the world's lightweight champion, Eduard Folayang of the Philippines. Nguyen edges forward. Folayang staying very loose, very relaxed. Fakes and feints here from Nguyen. Are you surprised by the tentative start from these two strikers here, Mitch?
Not at all, because of how dangerous each one of these athletes is. They can close the night with one big shot, so you have to be careful. You cannot jump in or expose yourself wildly and take any big risks. You've got to be calculated. This is the biggest championship match we've ever had.
Look at this, Nguyen dropping his hands, offering his chin, turning back into the midsection from Folayang. And Nguyen fakes that overhand right, as Chilson calls it, that hand grenade. Switching stance here for Folayang. Now Nguyen moves in for the first clinch of the contest. Folayang throws a short knee. A battle of strength now, who will prevail? Knees from Folayang, digs in the right hand. Another knee to the left waist of Nguyen. Nguyen tries to press the lightweight champion back against the fence. Look at the size of the biceps here and the deltoids on Folayang. You can really see the size difference between these two athletes now.
Liang's arms are the same size as Nguyen's legs.
Nguyen wants the top position. This is where he wants to get that grounded pound. And you see Folayang wraps the hands around him, wants to control the posture.
This first grappling exchange is telling us a lot. You can see that Folayang went for a head and arm throw and tried to throw him.
Overall, not round by round, turning back kick there from Folayang, looking for the sternum.
Look at the stance of Nguyen, hands down, inching forward. He's getting ready. He's getting ready. Look at him.
Jab to overhand right. It's the bread and butter combination of Martin Nguyen. Folayang has found success so far to the inside and outside lead thigh of the Aussie.
I like how he's in up that thigh. It's going to slow Nguyen down. He's not able to step and plant off that left leg and throw that big right hand or his very powerful lead hook. He's got a wonderful left hook that he was able to really rock Christian Lee with.
Goes hunting with a jaw with the legs here. Does Eduard Folayang then goes downstairs. Folayang still on the outside. Nguyen at center cage. There's the leg kick from Folayang. Little fake of the right hand there from Nguyen. Folayang turning back kick, trying to find the liver. Just got to tuck it under that ninth and tenth rib on the right side of the body of Martin Nguyen to effectively connect to the liver. Goes a little higher there off the left leg of the champion. Well, they're both champions. Competing for Folayang's belt. Oh, the high kick from Folayang! Tried to loop the shin around the back of the neck. Double underhooks here from Martin. And just pulls him off. Folayang goes headhunting again. The power now coming through on Eduard Folayang's salvos.
Nguyen seems very concerned with his hair. Beautifully timed leg kick again by Folayang.
Folayang establishing his power. Here in the second round, we are set for five. First time ever in one championship history. Champion versus champion. The featherweight champion, Nguyen. Oh, the big finish! A smart night, Irene!
Seen that from him before. Takes a kick to the leg and a right hand from the Chinese fighter.
Martin Nguyen knows he has the advantage here on the ground, but Lee Kai Wen has been working so hard. Nice little stuff there. Martin Nguyen went in for the take. And the big belly to back suplex there by Lee Kai Wen as he spins but gives up his back there as he attempts his back elbow.
It's a very fast paced start from Lee.
Don't grab the fingers, don't grab the gloves.
Lee Kai Wen's got big takedowns. He likes those suplexes. Looks Shane will show respect there.
Big bolo right hand, overhand right, like a fast bowler from his home country of Australia. Tried it again. That right hand comes from a way back and he delivers it quickly, just as Lee was coming in. I'll be wary of that next time he jumps into the attack.
Ooh, nice. Oh,
caught him well. Shot. Started off with a knee. The punches came in and then he goes for the takedown, but Nguyen defends it well.
Ooh, what a furious exchange by Lee Kai Wen. Oh, it all started.
Pick up from Nguyen. Superb single punch.
Big body kick, but Nguyen answers right back with a right hand of his own.
And the uppercut again. What a rocking blow that is. From Nguyen this time as the counter, and that is the fearsome weapon for the Australian, no question so far. Oh.
Both these fighters have been saying all week how they want to apply pressure and just come forward, and they're both just slamming into each other.
And Nguyen goes down. Tremendous punch from the Chinese man. They are so well matched, these two. What an entertaining brawl.
What a chin on Martin Nguyen to take that shot.
Second time he's shown a great deal of resilience to these hard punches.
That punch echoed around the stadium as Lee Kai Wen attempts to go for a kimura, possibly. He's got kind of a chicken wing there. Easy,
Just kind of soften him up. Nguyen with the big body shots there, just thumping on Li Kai Wen's body. Yeah, he can use this time now to just recover. If he was hurt from that big punch by Li Kai Wen, Nguyen can just sort of gain his composure and just recover fully. Li is hurt.
Li is bleeding from the nose, no doubt from some of the tremendous punching exchanges that these two have got themselves involved in.
Yeah, I think it was that first uppercut, Steve.
Yeah, will often do damage to a nose and uppercut.
Both these fighters are showing a huge heart and big chin to take shots like that.
We've seen some tremendous punching. Two super uppercuts from Nguyen and a sparkling left hook from Li. Will they be taking a breather on the deck here, Mitch, or is this just as hard work, only slightly different?
Man, after that shot.
Oh, the kick to the head. Technical ground kick, number two comes in. Number three. Oh, and the left hand there.
Big left hand.
Clean, and another one. And Lee's in trouble.
Oh, now he's jumping all over it. Looks like the break is over, and the rear naked choke is sunk in. He doesn't have the hooks in, so the leverage isn't there, but he can still finish from this. He chooses to let it go and just kind of control the back. He's got to work on that position before he attempts the submission. This is an amazing 4 minutes of action here.
The good news is there's still 50 seconds to go in this round if it goes that far, and we've got 2 5-minute rounds after this. It's a great contest.
You can see now he's got one hook in, and he's just choosing to do damage as he slides that second hook in. Now he's in a really good position to unload.
6 right-hand punches in a row coming through. Nguyen on top,
oh,
literally.
Flattened out, and Nguyen is unloading on him.
Olivier Coste is looking closely.
Li Kai Wen has got to move. He's got
it. The punches.
Gafarov, and Gafarov wants to try and stamp his authority and leaves himself open, particularly to that overhand right.
He landed it early, Michael snuck it in. Gafarov looked at him, shook his head, and said, let's go.
Ewan's corner believed that when Gafarov gets hit, he'll become frustrated. Oh, big right hand there from Gafarov, and stuns Ewan, and Ewan ties him up. Gafarov trying to get him on the canvas. That's where he'll go, to try and take Ewan's back.
Immediately, Gafarov lands sort of an uppercut hook on that right side, sneaks it in, now has the body clinch. Let's see if Martin Nguyen can defend the takedown. Oh, but he muscles his way in. Oh, no! Nguyen gives up his back. The body lock is on.
No, the finger four body lock. This is the beginning of the end, usually for opponents of Gafarov. Is it going to be the undoing of Martin Nguyen once again? Gafarov going for the rear naked. The finger four body lock is locked on. The body triangle. It'll suck the air out of Nguyen. It'll make it hard to breathe for the Australian.
Oh, what a big victory for Nguyen.
I can't believe he escaped it, Mitch. I've never seen that happen before.
He was right. He said it wouldn't happen. And he defends and gets back up to his feet.
Martin Nguyen, true to his word. He said Gafarov wouldn't be able to tap him out, even if he had his back tonight.
Oh, what does that do to the mindset of Gafarov? Nobody's gotten out of that. Nobody's been able to get away from the possible rear naked choke. And Nguyen takes him down.
Yeah, it's a good question to ask, Mitch. Is there a dent in the psyche now of the champion, Marat Gafarov? And Nguyen's confidence has got to be oozing after escaping from something that nobody's escaped from a figure four body triangle rear naked choke attempt from Marat Gafarov.
Gafarov's breathing kind of heavy. He needs to settle down, relax, realize that's what happens at this the highest level of martial arts.
Remember, Gafarov guaranteed the rear naked choke again. He guaranteed it in the first round. He said, sign the pink slips, sign the ownership papers. It's going to happen again. Nguyen showing patience now. Left hand from the Australian. The Aussie threaded it well, picking his shots.
Gafarov lands a left hand of his own.
Beautiful right hand over the top there. there from Martin Nguyen.
That overhand is landing over and over again on Gafarov. He attacks the lower part of the leg. I like that attack.
Gafarov not flailing in wildly. Good sticky jab once more from Nguyen. Gafarov throws up a front kick, a little lazy on the execution, however. Nguyen with the overhand right, he curls that overhand right with power like Mitchell Stark bowling pace for the Australian cricket team. Roundhouse kick there from Gafarov. Gafarov hopes for a takedown, puts Nguyen on his back, but Nguyen locks up the head, locks up the neck. What can Mark Nguyen do from here?
He's got an arm in guillotine, but it's tough to finish the BJJ black belt. Gafarov
will want to try and posture up. He wants to try and pass to the side of the body. Goes to half guard, goes to side control. Knee from Gafarov.
Nice. Nguyen's, oh, very good by Nguyen to get back into half guard. Gafarov had side control. He's going to try to lace that leg through. Get up on top, but good ground skills shown by Nguyen.
What an amazing matchup we're seeing in the first round here. Set for five, a brilliant contest for the World Featherweight Championship.
We're 1 minute away from one streak being ended. Martin Nguyen's four first round finishes, but we still got four more rounds to see Gafarov's streak extended.
Gafarov, former World Pancration Champion. Pancration as a sport dates to ancient Greece. And there's a knee to the jaw from Gafarov. Now to side control. Very aggressive knee on belly position for the Russian.
Cuts through that guard like a hot knife through butter. Tries to go knee on belly. He wants Nguyen to turn. He wants him to give it up. Oh, and he gets away again.
Nguyen does his finest Houdini impersonation and escapes from Marat Gafarov.
That's Nguyen two.
Glances towards Fari Selyevski in his corner, gives him a nod, says, I'm okay, boss.
Look at the grind from Gafarov to drag the fight back down to the ground. Tries to lock up the legs. Oh, he delivers a knee on the exit.
Nguyen does a quick count of his teeth after the... Gafarov fires a roundhouse kick. Nguyen catches it on the forearm. Switching stance again, the Australian-Vietnamese martial artist.
Gafarov pushing forward. He likes to throw big, flashy kicks because he's not scared to go to the ground. But that's exactly what he wants. He wants to take this fight to the ground, control and dominate his opponents.
Gafarov does a great job of curling these knees to the orbital. Looks to take the back here of Martin Nguyen. He's going to try and climb him and slap a rear naked choke that way. To no avail, Nguyen defends again. And now the corking knees from the Aussie.
True to his word so far, his defense in the grappling area has been stellar against that rear naked choke, Michael.
Nguyen shrugs him off.
Nice punch.
The chin a little high here on Gafarov. Now he puts the hands up. Can Nguyen capitalize? Maybe the jab to the overhand right. It's a bread and butter combination for the Aussie. And there it is!
Changes by Martin. He's just faking the takedowns. I want him to utilize that wrestling that he's got. It's highly underrated. I know he's a knockout specialist, but Martin Nguyen's got good wrestling. I'd like to see him utilize it here tonight.
Head kick there from Martin. Forearm brought up from Gorobets. Gorobets' stance very wide here. Fakes the right hand again. Drops the hands a little low. Got to be careful or Marty will come over the top.
Counter right hand there from Gorobets.
A lot of feints coming from Gorobets. He feinted a stance switch right there, but he went back to orthodox. A lot of frantic movement almost. He needs to settle down, maybe throw something out there, earn some respect early, because Martin's stalking him.
Extremely unorthodox from Gorobets early on. Came in oozing confidence out of every pore, the Ukrainian, in the lead up for this one. How will it play out though here on Wayne's debut? Marty switching stance.
You can see that, you know, Martin's needs to throw those leg kicks. He's got that, Gorobets has that wide stance, and it's perfectly ready for that mean low kick that Martin Nguyen's got. But you can just see he's always on the ball of his feet, moving around. Gorobets has got good lateral movement.
Left hook misses the target there for Gorobets on the outside, circling away from the right hand of Nguyen. Inside kick on, he cut him a little too low. Inside leg kick, nicely placed. Circles away counterclockwise.
Good movement.
High kick, but Martin saw it coming.
And see, Gorobets is hard to hit. That movement creates such angles that even Nguyen's having a hard time timing that low kick, too.
Wide stance again on Kirill Gorobets. High kick from Nguyen. Uppercut from Gorobets. Nguyen saw it coming. Roundhouse kick off the left leg from the Ukrainian. Continues to circle away from that right hand. We haven't really seen Marty go for it yet. Really load up the overhand right. Jump turning back kick there from Gorobets. Shoots in for a double driving takedown now.
Another one off the low kick, but Gorobets dove in on that double leg. Now this is where I've seen Gorobets really excel in the past, is his top control. He's got really good ground and pound, and he likes to punch into more advanced positions. So look for him to start striking, but Martin Nguyen's doing a good job of tying up that right arm.
Nice punch off the left arm there from Gorobets. Martin trying to lock that one down as well. Pushes himself back against the wire here, does Martin Nguyen.
Good job by Nguyen to get up against the wall and try to use that to work his way back up to his feet. Gorobets got the legs laced and he's gonna try to pull him away, but Martin Nguyen's hard to hold down.
Martin's always had good defense on the ground. Gorobets climbs on him there. Makes himself into a human backpack here.
Good back take. Nguyen's got to be careful. Good job right there. See how he took the right arm of Gorobets and brought it underneath his arm to avoid the choke. That was smart. Now he's just got to sit there and just kind of wait, you know? It's going to be hard for, you know, the referee to stop this position because it's a dominant position. But Gorobets changes things up.
Lots of instructions coming from the corner of Kirill Gorobets. And now Martin hoping to slap on a submission.
Jumping on the neck. Look at him, has that guillotine.
Ooh, nice knee to the top of the head there from Martin. Oh. There's the right hand to the side of the jaw. And you better believe Gorobets felt that one. Uppercut from Gorobets misses the target. But Martin starts to get a sniff in here with the hand.
Yeah, he's trying to time that overhand right. You can see Gorobets threw the right hand. Nguyen saw it coming, dipped out of the way, tried to time that right hand. That's a specialty of his. It's almost like he can tell the future when you start to throw that right hand. Look at that. Boom. Right there. Boom.
Nice counter right hand. Sprawls out now to Martin Nguyen, the former two-division world champion. Tried to line up the right. Gorobets knew it was coming.
30 seconds left in the first round.
Body shot. Dish him. Nice double forearms guard there from Martin Nguyen. Right hand from Marty, looping left. Can't get sloppy though, Martin Nguyen.
Pointing at him, saying, I got you.
Let's go.
I've got your number right there. Look at him, winging that right hand. Woo, that could have been lights out right there, Michael.
10 seconds.
Final 10 seconds of what's been a gripping 5 minutes. Both men have had their opportunities. Right hand from Gorobets. Tried to double up, jumping round kick. Vietnam, the Ukraine's Kirill Gorobets in the gray. Nguyen started to bring the heat towards the end of the first stanza. Gorobets again with this awkward, jittery stance of his.
I like Martin Nguyen's adjustment to the inside leg kick. Rather than taking those big outside leg kicks, he's starting to go to the inside. Just start piecing up that leg a little bit. Gorobets needs another takedown. Needs to start putting some punches together into the takedown.
There was the overhand right from Nguyen, just the side of the head though of Gorobets. Nguyen number 3 ranked in the division. Gorobets unranked on one debut tonight. Outside leg kick from Nguyen. Can't leave it hanging out there. As his coach has said, can't get sloppy. Shoots in for a double, driving takedown there from Gorobets.
Didn't have the punches behind it, but he did shoot in for a double leg. Martin immediately gets his back up against the wall. You can see what Gorobets is trying to do. He's trying to get, triangle the legs right there and then start to scoot his hips away from the ball. This is the battle. Can Martin Nguyen keep his back up against the wall and use it to get back up? And that he does.
You hear the instructions coming from Gorobets' corner as he just corks these knees into the outside thigh and hamstring area of Martin Nguyen. Another one there from Gorobets. Did they do any damage or are they just annoying, Dragon?
I think they do some damage, especially when he starts to rein back like that and really drive that knee into that thigh. It's the IT band, man. It's a delicate little area. There's not a lot of muscle there. It's all just that intersection between the quad and the hamstring. It can really numb your leg. And it can pay dividends later as the match wears on. It's like a leg kick.
I feel much educated after that, Dragon.
Dude, it's kind of like you. You know, you're the encyclopedia.
Over here.
You drop in anatomy lessons every now and then.
Oh, nicely done there from Gorobets. Really going to town on that right leg of Martin Nguyen. Hooks it now.
Nguyen needs to spin around. Throw that arm over the chest and get chest to chest. Just that.
Oh, that came agonizingly close with that counter left hook from Marty. Drifts back to center circle. Gorobets on the outside. Martin fakes the right. Not that one. And the left hand.
Beautiful.
Great two-punch combination, then a body shot from Martin Nguyen.
Yes.
And there is some reddening around the right side of the face and maybe a hematoma on Kirill Gorobets.
Patience, calm, stalking Martin Nguyen. Look at him. Kind of just cutting off the angles. You can see as Gorobets starts to circle to his right, which is doing away from the power side of Nguyen. Nguyen's trying to cut that angle and pin him right up against the wall so he can unleash that hammer of a right hand.
Martin trying to cut off the movement here of Gorobets. Outside leg kick from Kirill, side kick to the lead thigh. Resets himself here, Gorobets.
He's got to keep his hands up. He's dropping his hands down around his waist. I think he's getting a little fatigued right now. And Martin Nguyen's going to go headhunting.
Big body shot from Martin. You and the impact would be heard right around the stadium.
Look at that pressure coming from Nguyen as he's just trapping Gorobets up against that wall. Oh, lazy attempt on a takedown. Easy sprawl from Martin Nguyen as he starts to push the head down. Can Gorobets suck the leg back in?
Popping right hand there from Marty, still maintains his vertical base. Lifts him with the right to the jaw.
Good single leg control right there from Gorobets. Let's see if he can chain himself into a takedown here. Nguyen's doing a good job of pushing the head down. Where the head goes,
go
the body
action.
Will follow. Really important for Nguyen to push on that head and not allow Gorobets to posture up and get good control.
1 minute five remaining, second round set for three. Intriguing contest so far. This is Kirill Gorobets on debut against former two division world champion Martin Nguyen. Little uppercut to the inside there from Nguyen.
Nice elbow on the exit right there as Martin Nguyen was touching him. Good takedown defense. Shown
nice.
By Nguyen.
Inside leg kick from Gorobets. Had a thud behind it. No right hand after the jab there from Martin. There's the right hand now.
Oh,
Gorobets turns his back. That's dangerous. And he gets caught. He turned away and he got caught by the right hand. Now the elbows from Martin Nguyen.
30 seconds. This is important for Gorobets.
That's some
nice
sloppy
job.
Defense from Gorobets running away like that, turning his back.
Goes to the body.
The body's hurt. He's going. He's going.
Oh, is he going to be saved by the bell?
He's going.
10 seconds. Finish
it. Finish it. Finish it. Is this it? Can Martin finish? Gorobets to the hole of the bother. Jab there from Gorobets. Martin still looking fresh. Gorobets' face looking a little worse for wear. Inside thigh kick from the Ukrainian. He's finding out that this is not like ravaging Europe. This is one championship. This is a former two-division world champion he's up against. And Marty sprawls out.
This is a good move by Gorobets, but he's got to stay close. He's got to get inside that clinch. He's
high
got to try to close down this offense coming from Nguyen.
Patience here from Martin, not letting that emotion get the better of him as it may have during the Tun Lee title loss. Gorobets' hands low, don't go running away again, Kirill, you're gonna get caught. The hands are low, he's breathing heavy here.
The leg kicks are still there for Nguyen, I like that, look at the hands. Gorobets has got to keep those hands up, especially that left. He's got to stay nice and tight. He's also get moving. That movement that he had in the first five is gone.
Is Kirill Gorobets ripe for the picking? He shoots in a slow double leg attempt, and Marty escapes easily.
Body
shot.
There it is.
Oh, belly button through the back. Big right hand from Martin Nguyen. Gorobets taking punishment. Cuts over his face, a bump on the bridge of his nose, a hematoma to the side of the head. And Martin taking his time, picking his shots. Sets the right hand. Gorobets hands are low. Martin looking for the right time, saw the overhand coming. Jab two, Martin saw that one coming as well. Steps off a little angle, scoops towards the body.
Yeah, the big punches are telegraphed from Gorobets, and look at him just digging into the body.
Gorobets could hardly breathe, his mouth wide open.
Gasping he takes for his the knee, that's
over.
It.
He's set that's, down, it's going to be over, come on! Can Marty finish him now? Gorobets is hurt, Gorobets is tired.
He's a stationary target.
Punishing him, body, head, body, head. Gorobets is done for, he's done for. That's good night, Irene! Watch out for the Mawashigeti roundhouse kicks of the Kyokushin Karateka Matsushima. Look out for the overhand rides of Martin Nguyen.
Lots of movement coming from Matsushima as he's changing stances, looking for that lead leg of Martin Nguyen. Whether it's going to be an inside leg kick or it's going to be a single leg takedown, he's going to start to hammer on that lead leg of Martin Nguyen.
Fake throw from Matsushima. Quite a few Australians in the audience here in Manila tonight. Thanks again from Matsushima, switching stance between southpaw and orthodox. Nguyen goes upstairs, tries for a round kick of his own. Not beyond his comfort zone to throw the round kicks high, Martin Nguyen, but hands is where he's more proficient. And a sucker in Matsushima. Matsushima goes for the outside lead thigh. Kyokushin karate, known as the hardest form of karate. The karate style possessing the hardest roundhouse kicks. System developed by the late Soso Masoyama.
See, a lot of this movement is starting to get Martin a little bit confused. He was having a hard time judging that distance, and that was a beautiful double leg takedown from Matsushima right there as he slid in. Now he's trying to control that right wrist of Martin Nguyen. I think he's going to try to shove it to the other side so we can kind of handcuff him.
Martin Nguyen very relaxed here, off of his back, pinning the wrist as Matsushima. Close guard from Nguyen, opens it up now, closes it once more, the Australian.
Nice little slap there to the side of the ear there, beating up the cauliflower.
Just a little finger in the eye. Elbows from Martin Nguyen, the champion, back to his feet, avoids the round kick. Matsushima had an opportunity. Nguyen a little too slick though, a little too evasive.
Lots of pressure coming from Matsushima right off the bat. Nguyen's like, all right, now it's my turn. I'm going to come forward. I'm going to put you on your back foot.
Matsushima throwing it overhand right. Nguyen sets his own, doesn't throw it though. Goes to the round kick there from Matsushima. Nguyen ties him up, takes him for a ride. Does Matsushima.
This is what Matsushima did to Kwon Wan Il. Just every time he started to think about the exchanges, Matsushima was all over his legs, jumping all over him, trying to shut that down. Martin Yen's got very good wrestling. We've seen that a lot in his past matches. He has a great sprawl, very heavy hips.
Martin Nguyen perhaps did not expect such an aggressive start from Matsushima. Matsushima, Mawashigeri, Nguyen checks it on the forearm. Comes forward now, does the champion. Outside leg kick from Nguyen. Matsushima, chin very low. Martin, not Nguyen could try and pop him with an uppercut. Chin's hanging out there, thrusts out the jab. Overhand right from Matsushima. Outside leg kick, Matsushima. Nguyen probing with the lead hand. Matsushima shot in wide, but there was no rising knee as Nguyen predicted he would do. Although I do believe the opportunity is there, Mitch.
Yeah, he's coming forward. He kind of overextends on his double leg takedown. He gets really long, but what that's doing is it's giving him a little bit extra reach, so he's able to wrap the hands around the legs of Martin Nguyen as Martin Nguyen sprawls. But it does leave him open to attacks up the middle as well.
Fake there from Matsushima. Nguyen yet to really launch the heavy artillery. Matsushima has been the aggressor of the two. Some elbows now from Nguyen on the ground, posts up on the left arm.
It's the way he shoots in for that takedown, the way he laces up the legs. Martin Nguyen's going to have to time that a little bit better and back up a little bit more. As he starts to go battle royale and go into the top rope.
Let's go. You need to stay inside the ring. You need to stay inside the ring. Keep going.
Olivia comes to
that. Last one is stay inside the ring.
World champion. Good sign of sportsmanship and a moment of honor there. Two punch combination from Nguyen. Fakes there. Punt kick from Matsushima. Wasn't quite a Maigedi front kick. Again, that shin just dropped down low for a moment. I don't know why Matsushima does that necessarily. Shoots in for a low single, sucker up the
high knee! Overhand right from Nguyen, but he caught him with the high knee.
There's that knee off the double leg takedown. It was more of a...
Revenge Arena in Manila, the Philippines. Up kick there from Matsushima.
And that's what he's looking for. He's looking to go straight into the body of Martin Nguyen. Good defense there from Martin Nguyen as he sprawled heavy on the Matsushima double leg.
Stiff Kakuzuki punching from the Kyokushin Karateka. Nguyen fakes. Matsushima trying to cut an awkward angle on his way in, and Mark Nguyen just nods at him and says, yep, that was pretty cagey. Outside thigh from Nguyen. Jab to right hook from Nguyen. And since Martin Nguyen starting to up the power now. Flying knee from the Australian Vietnamese.
He was expecting a double leg on that one. Matsushima just thought better of it. Caught it on the chest there.
Sprawls out nicely to Nguyen. Had to watch out for the hook on the upcome.
I'd like to see Matsushima put a little bit more takedowns together rather than just shooting for one sprawl, which Martin Nguyen's kind of heavy sprawling out. Keep going with it. Dig for those single legs after Martin Nguyen pops back up to his knees. He's trying to go up the middle with that rear push kick.
Nguyen edges forward. Is he going to set that overhand right that he's known for? The one that knocked out Folayang, the one that knocked out Gaffer up. He's throwing the overhand right now. See, he goes down the body.
He's starting to drop his hands a little bit, especially when he switches to southpaw. Looks like Martin's got that timing on that leg, on that sprawl down.
Ground and pound now from the champion.
Big shots landed from the champion as Matsushima gets that single leg.
Reverse elbows to the body. What's Matsushima looking for here, Mitch?
He's trying to suck in that right leg, pull that right leg into his chest, but Nguyen's got spectacular takedown defense. He might be able to take the back here as he grounds and pounds him.
Watch out!
Chooses to go for the knee ride. Nice little escape there from Martin Nguyen as Matsushima kept hunting for that single leg.
There's the overhand right from Nguyen. Almost timed it to perfection.
Matsushima's got to be careful with keeping those hands low, especially when he comes in for the exchange. He's kind of right in the middle of the pocket with his hands down.
Just in his stance, Mitch, he just tends to droop forward a lot with his chin. You see how far forward his chin is right there? The hands are low on Matsushima. Could spell danger for the Japanese challenger. That does not come from his Kyokushin background. Kyokushin, they're very straight up in their guard, in their stance. Sprawled out from Martin Nguyen. Oh, there's a nice hooking right hand from Nguyen. He goes to the orbital. Matsushima forced to back off.
Nguyen's making him pay for these takedown attempts. Every time he misses a double leg, Martin Nguyen's landed a few punches in the sprawl.
Matsushima's hands are so low. Look how low they are. The chin is hanging out there. Will Nguyen catch it? Big kick, body shot from Nguyen, rips it into the liver. Double jab. Nguyen wants to lock him in the corner, throw the heavy artillery. And Matsushima. And it's stuck now. Oh, there's the right hand smack back! He tagged him! The big right hand from Martin Nguyen! And Matsushima's hurt! He's at a standstill!
How patient Nguyen is!
Matsushima's hurt! Nguyen, though, like you said, Mitch, showing patience. He knows that Matsushima's got many tricks. Here comes Nguyen. Backs off. Loops the right hand. Matsushima back against the ropes. Oh, he catches him with a hook! Matsushima taking some heavy blows.
Matsushima's got a chin. There were some big shots landed by Martin. He slept a lot more people with those shots.
Oh, cracking roundhouse kick. The tags of the game. Matsushima in a whole world of hurt. Martin Nguyen teeth opening like a golf course. Here he goes. He's battering away.
Might be it.
Is it going to be the end? Okay, Marty, let's go.
He's faking it out. Ooh, a charging double leg. Wow. Lead leg of Nguyen. Nguyen shoots in for the double leg, spins around.
Nguyen.
Sort of an unorthodox defense, but it seems he's landed.
Full guard,
where both legs are wrapped around. And Nguyen's attempting an armbar here.
Armbar, possibly. Slips out. Wushu stance so familiar from Kelly.
Yeah, Kelly says he's been putting a lot of work out there with the Team Lakai camp in Baguio, Philippines. And Martin Nguyen actually has not stopped his camp since his last contest. So after the loss to Mara Agafarov, he jumped right back into camp, didn't take any time off, and jumped right back into training. So he feels he's in the best shape of his life.
No rest for the wicked, that's what they say. Inside leg kick. Absolutely snapped in and out. Kelly, very, very quick feet.
Yeah, that
and,
wushu
and heavy
style,
too, right?
That wushu style lead sidekick is just explosive. They use it like a jab. It's just so effective. Landing, you can just see him landing it there to the lead leg of Nguyen. Nguyen shoots in for the double leg, spins around, and is looks like he's climbing up onto the back of Eduard Kelly here. Let's see as he tries to take off this arm that's over his shoulder like that. You can see he's got to try to spin and get chest to chest with Nguyen here.
Nguyen.
Sort of an unorthodox defense, but it seems he's landed into half guard of Martin Nguyen, and Nguyen pulls back into full guard where both legs are wrapped around. And Nguyen's attempting an armbar here.
Armbar, possibly. Slips out. I think Nguyen may have got a punch in the eye there. It just set it back a little moment, but no claims of any illegality, nor that there would be a stoppage.
This is a big fight for both these fighters at this point in their careers right now. It'll send the winner catapulting right back into title contention.
A little fake there from Nguyen, who's an extremely polite man outside of the cage.
At the beginning of the fight, he told Kelly to have fun. And that's rare. You never have fun. You just have fun, man. Just enjoy yourself.
While I beat you up.
Or an attempt to. He's faking it out. Ooh, a charging double leg.
Wow,
takedown.
Like a bull in a china shop with slightly more control.
Shoots halfway across the cage. Look at your left. And just working from the guard. Let's see what Eduard Kelly's good. Like off his back.
Good. Palm elbow.
Right now, pressed up against that cage, he really doesn't have any space to move his hips or to attempt any possible submissions. But he can use the cage to start walking back up and possibly get back up to his feet.
Watch out, back of the head. Watch out, back of the head. Watch out.
Olivier Koss warning Eduard Kelly about the shots to the back of the head.
Your left is free for the body.
Well, right now, he's got his right hand around the back.
And that's really just to control the posture of Martin so he can't pop his head up and land any big blows. But Martin seems content just to kind of bury his head into Edward's chest. And now he's trying to work into a possible guillotine here. But you can see Martin's got his head really high up, so it's even easy to pop out of there, and it's hard to finish that.
Kelly definitely putting the effort in. You can see the grimace on his face. Nice, slipped out.
See, now he's starting to, that opened him up right in the top of the forehead. That was a nice elbow landing.
Heavy
clean
blow. You heard it as well, Mitch.
And it just sliced a nice little cut right on the top of Edward. Now it's bleeding right out of his.
1 minute.
So a big problem for Edward Kelly, having to deal with that injury.
Martin's just kind of taking his time, you know, using the ground and pound to his advantage.
And Kelly's face is a bit of a mess. Olivier Coste is going to call time so that the doctors can have a look at that. Quite often, a cut can look an awful lot worse than it actually is. And we need the doctors to come in and just confirm that that's the case. Nguyen taking the opportunity to get a bit of a rub down, and he had some interaction with the crowd as well, trying to get them involved.
If the fight is stopped right here, what happens?
If the fight is stopped right here, it'd be ruled a no contest because the fight has to reach the midway point before it can actually go to the judges' scorecard.
Well, the fight's been stopped, but I think what happened was the cut was not an accident.
No, I stand corrected. The fight gets
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Olivier Coste calls a halt to this battle at 4 minutes, 17 seconds of round number one. Due to doctor stoppage, due to a deep cut on the forehead, for your winner, out of the red corner, Martin Nguyen!
Be a good one. A very distinct possibility of a title challenge sometime in 2017. For the winner, big prize on offer. Some might say a whopper.
Both fighters want nothing more than to get back to that title shot. And that was a Burger King reference there from Steve Dawson. But we're seeing a nice relaxed style from Yokota. His nickname is Hage Haya, which means fast baldy.
Which is fantastic, isn't it?
By
a great nickname.
Teammates, but we could have a battle of the best nicknames here between the Situasian Martin Nguyen and Fast Baldy.
I've got to give it to Fast Baldy, I'm afraid. But Nguyen has an awful lot to offer above and beyond nicknames here. In comes that flying teep kick from Yokota. And Nguyen was alert enough to back away from that and the follow-up punches. You can see he's cocking that right leg, Yokota, all the time, just looking to do something with it.
Nguyen has told me that he wants to be a little bit more patient in this fight. He kind of lets emotions take over and he rushes in and he makes a little bit of mistakes sometimes. So he wants to be a little more patient and he really wants to be relaxed and composed in at least the first round of this fight.
Just as Yokota came in, Nguyen's overhand right looked to land. Caught quite a bit of glove, I think. That's how focused he is and how sharp the 27-year-old is.
We saw some of previous Nguyen's fights. He's got a big overhand right, and you can see the way Yokota is kind of inching his chin out there. He's not really keeping his chin tucked, and he just got caught right there by a right hand. So he's got to keep that chin a little bit down because Nguyen's got a powerful right hand.
He's throwing it, he's faking it. It's gonna be the dominant weapon in these early moments anyway. There it is again, countering the left jab. It came over the top of the jab. And Yokota will have had a good view of that already. Let's see what he's gonna do about it. The way Nguyen beat Christian Lee, who had such a lot of attention and deservedly so, it was something of a destruction and really raised his profile at the back end of a very, very substantial 14 months for this Australian fighter, the Situasian.
Action!
See how composed and relaxed your coach is. He's threatening that foot. He's really kind of lifting that back leg up to sort of threaten that rear leg push kick.
That overhand right is genuinely overhand, isn't it? The elbow is actually higher than the glove when it lands.
Yeah, Martin Nguyen throws a beautiful right hand, like he's throwing a baseball almost with that right hand. But and the way Yokota's got his hands down and his chin out, that's like it plays perfectly into that weapon of Nguyen's. Lots of feints, though, coming from Yokota.
Yeah, there are a lot.
So as you can see, it's kind of affected Martin. Like, he doesn't really know exactly what's coming from Yokota.
He wants that right leg, doesn't he, to... Oh, there's a big overhand right counterpunch. And he's certainly hurt, and Olivier Goss jumps in, and Martin Nguyen...
Seats. They've been trained, and it's Lee who draws the short straw. Fake now from Lee. They're playing mind games here, Mitch.
As Lee threw that jab, Martin came right over the top with that right hand. His timing, pay attention to it.
Fake there from Martin Nguyen. Both athletes, plenty of fakes and feints inside the opening minute. Nguyen edging forward, closing the distance, just testing the waters with a high kick. Fakes again, does Martin. Lee high the ball to his feet, switching stance a little. Palms turned out on Christian Lee. A chance go up for the warrior. Christian Lee gets out of the way of the left hand. Nguyen resets.
A lot of respect shown here by both, as Christian Lee slides in for a body lock.
Cross the bricks.
Clinching up against the cage here. Takedown. Nguyen dangerously put the left arm out, trying to post on it. Side control now for Christian Lee. Good position for the teenager.
Wow, Michael, big takedown from Christian Lee. That's something Bibiano couldn't do, as Christian Lee passes into mount.
How about this full mount on Martin Nguyen from Christian Lee? Not even halfway through the opening round. Dominant position for Christian Lee.
Very dominant position. This is a very awkward spot for Martin Nguyen, but look how he slides those hips out. Gets on top of the guillotine.
Christian Lee trying to choke out the Australian. The crowd rallying behind Lee, but Nguyen's safe for the moment.
Wow, and he drops down, has a darce locked in tight. Here comes some knees. Marty is trying to shield the knees. We've seen this before. We've seen this from Christian. He likes to drag him down. Slap on that anaconda, lacing the legs.
He predicted an anaconda finish. Did Christian Lee tries to drag him down again. Martin still stuck in this position. A bad predicament for the Australian. How does Martin get out of this?
He's got to fight. First of all, he's got to create a little bit of space on the choke. Oh, beautiful. And he slides his head out.
That's going to make Martin Nguyen angry. Let's see what Martin Nguyen responds with. And Lee is oozing with confidence. Puts the gloves up high, as well he should.
That's a lot of control right there. That was a lot of ground control from Christian Lee. That's got to be a huge boost to his already sky-high confidence.
Did it take any effect on the stamina? Did it inflict any pain on Martin Nguyen? Outside leg kick from Nguyen.
There was two choke attempts, one with a guillotine, one with a possible darce right there, but Christian Lee is very relaxed. He wasn't straining on it. He wasn't trying to, you know, do too much with it, and he let it go once he realized Martin Nguyen was going to pop his head out.
Fake off the back leg from Martin. Lee being very cerebral, not choosing to rush and overextend himself to lend himself to a counter from Martin Nguyen. Martin thought about the overhand right.
1 minute in the first round.
Doesn't want to telegraph it. circling into the power hand, Christian Lee. Oh, right hand down the tube. How do you do?
Beautiful timing from Christian Lee to slip that right hand in.
But Lee is drifting into Martin's right hand, Mitch.
Yeah, and that right hand is a game changer. It can immediately change the course of this match. Christian Lee's looking very sharp now. Martin Ian stalking, cutting him off at every
round. Don't forget, we do judge on an overall bout, not round by round. Though thus far, you'd have to be giving the contest to Christian Lee. There's the right hand from Nguyen. Lee doing everything right. Focused, sharp, thinking, strategy from the warrior. If Christian wins this one and Angela wins the main event, we will have Sibley world champions.
Has there ever been a brother and sister combination like Christian and Angela?
That competed at world championship at the highest level? I don't think so. Outside leg kick from Nguyen. Tentative start to this round from Christian Lee. Look at the range on the arms here of Lee. Thrust out that very long jab as a 19-year-old.
Christian Lee has the reach advantage, but I think the power advantage is going to go to Nguyen.
I would agree with you there, Mitch. Checks the low kick to Lee. Nguyen favoring the low kicks here. The more you kick the legs of Lee, the harder it is for Lee to shoot in on Nguyen. Also makes it more difficult to box. Yuji Shimada wants to see more action from these two men. Second round of five.
This is a high-stakes chess game going on here, Yuji. You gotta let these combatants play it out.
Overhead right charges into a clean timing from Martin. And a takedown, no, from Lee. Martin defends him.
Nguyen swims under, gets the pummel going on, and successfully defends a takedown attempt from Christian Lee.
Tried from Australian rules football kick at the end there, did Martin Nguyen. Circling into the power side again, dangerously, as Christian Lee is doing a Beyonce to the left, to the left. Needs to be going the other way, to the right, to the right. I know you're a Beyonce fan, Mitch.
Oh, yeah.
Nguyen controlling center cage.
Nguyen's looking for that big hammer. You can see him inching forward, trying to pick it apart. There, he just missed it right now.
He didn't have the timing nor the distance. There's the left hand, there's the right hand! He caught him between the eyes. And still Christian Lee circles into that power side.
Maybe he's not fearing the right hand. Maybe he thinks his head movement and chin can take that hammer.
Fake there from Lee. 1 minute 50 remaining. Second round on the edge of our seats here inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Overhand right from Nguyen.
Beautiful slide under. Good defense from Nguyen.
Nguyen stuffing the takedown attempt. Couldn't do so in the first round. Has done in the second round. And he's loving those outside leg kicks. Long-reaching jab from Lee.
I'd like to see Lee use more of that jab.
Martin Nguyen. Can he cut off the lateral movement of the teenager?
Maybe he wants to soften him up with some leg kicks. Slow down the footwork of Lee. Get him to stand in front of him so he can unload those hands.
This has been a better one. Most leg kicks are landing. They'll be scoring for him.
Definitely. Better striking round from Nguyen.
Striking superiority is a category the judges score on. It's going to Nguyen in this round. Takedown defense is also another scoring category. That goes to Martin Nguyen.
The crowd is getting riled up here, looking for that GoDaddy knockout of the night.
Long reach, full extension of the punches from Christian Lee, looking for a body long. Couldn't get it. Jab two from Nguyen. And there's the hook. Lee circles out of trouble.
It looks like Nguyen's starting to figure out the timing and the distance of Christian Lee.
They've competed before. It was Martin Nguyen who came up trumps years ago. Lee says he's far removed from the athlete who lost to Nguyen last time.
This is a different Christian Lee. You can see from his everything, from his stance to his footwork. This is a different guy.
Thanks for the point.
Back
on releasing the overhand right on that occasion.
Yeah, he just can't seem to find the distance. That's where he's most successful, is luring people in and then connecting with that right hand. This is a very important battle right here. Very important.
What are we seeing here, Mitch?
He's got the Whizzer on the left side, how he's applying shoulder pressure with an overhook, how his arm is over the right hand of Christian. Now, he's able to pry him up to successfully defend with that knee. That's what we saw in the Viviano, is that defensive wrestling from Nguyen. We haven't seen any offensive wrestling, but the defensive wrestling from Martin Nguyen is stellar.
But will it win Martin Nguyen this bout? Goes for the outside leg kick, misses the target. Jab, falls short. Where was the right hand for company from Martin Nguyen? Can't throw the single punches, needs to go the combinations. Hope to land something to the jaw of the teenager, Christian Lee. Laser-like intensity in the eyes of Lee. Thrusts out that rear hand.
Doubles up on it, I like how he did that. Those little touches, they may not be hurting Martin, but they are scoring the eyes of the judges. Any little touch is gonna count.
Looks for the outside leg again, there's Nguyen. Still not finding that range, goes upstairs. Flicks the toes to the jaw. There's the overhand right from Nguyen. Gotta be careful not to leave that lead hand dangling out there, Christian Lee, or Nguyen will counter with the right hand. Body shot, lead hand from Nguyen. Fakes the overhand right, does Nguyen. What an intriguing match.
Nguyen's got great eyes. You can see him intently focused on exactly what Christian's doing. I like that low kick, Michael. He needs more of that.
It's surprising there that Nguyen didn't go after Christian Lee, who was almost off balance. Yuji Shimada is cautioning him again. He wants to see more action. I believe Martin's striking is the better of the two in this round so far. Not by much, though. There's really not a lot in it. Certainly nothing decisive for either man. Roundhouse kick to the head there from Nguyen. Lee charges forward. No counter, though, from Nguyen. Lee with the jab, throws the jab well, does the 19-year-old. Will Martin Nguyen start changing angles? There's a jab again from Lee. Yuji's gonna get the yellow card out. Martin Nguyen throwing his arms out, said something to his coach, Barry Sayevsky. He's frustrated here.
This level is a real championship match. You gotta let these guys play. You gotta let them put it all out there.
Nguyen trying to cut off the lateral movement now of Christian Lee. Lee jabbing. His guard is wide open. Can Martin Nguyen go up the center corridor? There's a good jab, threaded through the eye of the needle.
Nguyen's pushing forward, trying to cut the angles off. Martin Nguyen with the takedown attempt, using his body lock. Not afraid to grapple with this submission specialist.
Yes. Yes.
There's the knee right in front of his corner, receiving instructions now from the KMA team is Martin Nguyen. Those knees will score for him in the striking category and the aggression category. Martin Nguyen throws those knees continually to the outside thigh, then goes to the inside thigh. Ending, time for someone, Mitch, to put the foot down, to apply the pressure.
That's what Christian Lee just tried to do there. He tried to punch his way into a double leg. Martin Nguyen spun him off.
High kick from Nguyen.
Now they look like they're both starting to take a little bit bigger risks with each other, trying to explode in some of these striking exchanges.
Martin Nguyen, two-division champion, holds the featherweight gold, holds the lightweight gold. Defeated Marek Gafarov for the strap he's defending tonight. Knocked out Eduard Folayang for the lightweight title in Manila.
Martin Nguyen's trying to throw that question mark kick, but he's tried three times almost naked. Hasn't really set had a setup behind it. He's just trying to throw that head kick.
Yuji Shimada's influence has got these two moving here in the fourth round. Oh, there's a left hand from Christian Lee.
Good movement by Nguyen.
Outside leg kick from Nguyen. Nicely done from the Aussie. Jab, looks for a takedown. Single leg here from Christian Lee. Martin prevents the takedown.
He's got exceptional balance on that one leg. He does it so well by shielding with his left leg, creating a little bit of space with the knee, and creating balance on that right leg.
We really are seeing some high-level martial arts at the moment from both of these young men. Pressing Nguyen against the cage. Is Christian Lee takes a beautiful move to the big basket. Almost gets it knocked out, a takedown. And Martin Nguyen posted up in the arm. Back to his feet again, Nguyen. He won't go down. He doesn't want to be on his back.
It's that defensive wrestling. So good from Martin Nguyen. So hard to keep him down. I was surprised when Christian Lee was able to keep him down in the first round, but they were both dry. They weren't sweaty.
Overhand right just behind the ear there from Martin Nguyen. There's the jab from the Aussie. Needs to throw the combinations, though, especially after the jab. Nguyen resets. Christian Lee working angles left and right. Now drifting into the right hand, and there it is from Martin Nguyen. Almost unbuckled him.
Caught Christian on the top of the head, wobbled him just a bit. I think that was more of a balance issue than an effect of the shot.
High kick from Nguyen. There's not much in it, but the output of striking is slightly higher from Martin Nguyen.
He's got the aggression, he's moving forward.
Takedown defense, another category we score on. Nguyen has been defending the takedown, been no successful takedown in this round, nor the last round for Christian Lee. Now the crowd trying to rally behind Lee. There's a takedown from Nguyen. Top position from the chair. Can he go to the ground and pound there? Look at the aggression from Nguyen. The ground and pound. The elbows, the fist, the knuckles curled in. Martin Nguyen grinding. Forearm across the throat of Christian Lee.
No.
Oh, that is an uncomfortable choke from Martin Nguyen. Just a put the forearm across the choke and grind on him.
Dragon, this is where Nguyen said he wanted to be. He wanted to be there in the first round. He finds himself there in the fourth round.
Now we're starting to see that aggression come out that Coach Fari was talking about, that Mr. Hyde type attitude.
1 minute.
You can see Christian trying to shoot up the arm bars, trying to swivel his hips.
And he's powering through. Body shots now from the champion. This has certainly turned the tide in Martin's favor. The aggression, the ground and pound, the takedown was successful. Another clean left hand to the jaw of Christian Lee. Hammer fist strikes now from Nguyen. Can't leave the arm in. Slides it out. Trying to stack it now.
Oh, passes almost. Good job by Christian to recover guard. Martin Nguyen trying to flip around.
Gotta watch those long legs coming up from Christian Lee. Everything dangerous. Now back to their foot. This crowd running for Christian Lee. And Martin Nguyen turned up the aggressive meter. Got the takedown, got the ground and pound, did the damage. And now it's Lee. He's gonna go back to his corner and get some money.
Michael, what do you think? Does it come down to the fifth and final round?
Oh, it does indeed. I've got Martin Nguyen ahead at the moment, slightly ahead, but it comes down for this final 5 minutes.
Oh, beautiful head movement. Do you see that? Martin Nguyen slid out of the way to the right as Christian Lee stuck his hand in the fence.
High kick from Martin Nguyen, gets out of the way of the counter left hand. Nguyen fakes. Fake there from Christian Lee.
Then look to go low and change levels. Lee does that, and Martin spoils the takedown attempt.
This is where that championship experience, going five rounds with a bantamweight king, Viviano Fernandez, is going to be so important for Martin Nguyen. He knows what it's like to be in these situations and what he has to do. He doesn't want to make the same mistake he made with Viviano. He didn't feel like he left everything in the cage. Now is his opportunity to do that.
1 minute left. Goodbye.
3 minutes 55 remaining. Nguyen edging forward. Lee's a little more flat-footed now. Could be time for Martin to uncork that overhand right.
And also set up into that double leg takedown. So you can see him probably going to throw the overhand right, shooting him for a takedown, putting Christian Lee on his back.
Lee.
Christian Lee shoots him for the takedown.
That's been the setup for the takedown throughout the entire bout. Thrust the right hand down the center, shooting quickly, but not effective on this occasion. Still looking for a takedown here, Christian Lee.
Good job. This is where Martin shows his championship mentality and skill. Good job to defend the single leg yet again.
3 minutes now. The championship final round.
Christian Lee's trying to put pressure on the champion, but you have to take the belt from the champion. You can't leave no question. You have to take the champion's belt.
A nice evasion there from Martin. Fires an uppercut. There's a left hand. He backs up Christian Lee.
That was beautiful.
Slick head movement, slick countering from Martin Nguyen, the champion in the black trunks. Christian Lee now needs to go forward himself. He throws an overhand right and slips. The jab, but Martin too elusive, too slick. It's time for Christian Lee to start throwing caution to the wind.
You can see Christian Lee's not moving the same. Those low leg kicks from Martin Nguyen have done the damage. Christian Lee's even starting to switch stances.
Fatigue may be setting in on the teenager. As Mitch said, the leg kicks may be taking their toll. He's tasted the power of Nguyen. Tries for a low Sakuraba-style single leg. Maybe getting frustrated that he hasn't managed to take Nguyen down as he did very early on in the contest. At a time when he had full mount, right, Mitch, on Martin Nguyen.
Yep, very dominant position to end the first round. Confidence had to be exploding through the roof. But wow, how the tide has turned. But Christian Lee is only 19 years old. You have to understand that this match, if it doesn't go in his favor in the judges' eyes, is only going to lead to a more exceptional Warrior Lee.
Big looping left hand there from Nguyen. The clock ticks down. Time now may be the enemy of Christian Lee.
But he's done a lot in this match. Michael, he's really shown an improved Christian Lee.
Ollie has his first round was superb, but the dominance hasn't been there since. Martin Nguyen shoots in on Lee now. Can Nguyen get a takedown? Drills a knee to the bread basket. Spins around and takes the base down. There's a corking knee. There's one to the hamstring. 1 minute remaining. Good trajectory on the knee from Nguyen. Staying busy. Landing his strikes. It's scoring stuff for the champion dragon.
Look for Nguyen to spin to his right, stick his leg out, and drag this one to the ground. If he's finished the round, last 40 seconds with a little bit of ground and pound.
These knees may not be doing a lot of damage, but it's the work rate from Martin Nguyen. Let's see if Lee can go kleptomaniac and try and steal it in the final second. The crowd in Singapore are roaring. They want Lee to find something. 15 seconds on the clock now. Big leg kick from Martin Nguyen. That hurt him. That hurt his shin. That hurt his shin. Martin Nguyen cracking leg kick. Goes high. Glancing. Real left hand there. From
Martin Nguyen.
Stadium, this legendary venue Nguyen ranked number 4, and Kasabi looking to take him down here tonight.
Yeah, pay close attention to those calf kicks thrown by Martin Nguyen. He takes out the lower part of your leg like none other in the featherweight division. As Kasabi says, Mitch, I'll change your mind on that. I got calf kicks too.
Yeah, you can see Kasabi with that backward motion like he's coiling on that back leg, just looking to draw Nguyen in and unload that right hand.
Kasabi's got that wide stance, similar to Tan Lee, gave the Martin Nguyen a lot of problems in their title matchup. Big wide hook thrown by Kasabi. Let's see if Kasabi can find some of those same kind of angles and those movements that the elusive Tan Lee did. Trying to pull Martin Nguyen in some of these big punches as Kasabi continues to try to chop down the legs of Martin Nguyen.
Kasabi was smart to go back to the kick right there because he was swinging big and Martin was starting to read the timing of those hands.
Martin Nguyen cutting the angles off well, trying to trap Kasabi in that corner. Big power out of that right hand thrown by Martin Nguyen. Like to see him start setting things up though with that jab. Nguyen's got a beautiful jab. Let's see if he starts to utilize it.
How about the mindset, Rich, of Kasabi? It feels like you can go into this saying you got nothing to lose playing with house money. Is it accurate?
I always hate the phrase nothing to lose because you have a fight to lose and it's a big deal. But for him, this is an opportunity. We talked to him about that this week and he said, man, when something like this comes your way, former two division champ, like you don't pass an opportunity like this up.
But the thing is you can lose your consciousness fighting Martin Nguyen. He will put you to sleep and you will be waking up looking at those pretty little ring lights with one momentary lapse of concentration. So you can lose a lot here. And this is a huge opportunity for Kasabi to really go in there against a top level featherweight contender and make his statement by announcing himself to the world.
Let's be clear, maybe Nguyen has lost 3 of his last 4, but he's still only 33 years of age. Definitely feels like he can get back to the top and get a world title in this division once again.
Yeah, I'm a little shocked though that Nguyen here isn't putting some things in Kasadi's face. The jab, particularly as Mitch was talking about earlier, giving him something to talk about because he's just allowing Kasabi to move forward.
Sleep, turning Kasabi into a grapple.
Huge knee from Nguyen on the way up.
Yeah, that was a desperation shot for sure. Kasabi now realizes he's in a real fight.
Kasabi tried for the takedown after taking a huge overhand right. And then when he didn't get it on their way up, a big knee there from Nguyen.
You can see Kasadi's stance is starting to get really static here. He's moving less and less. And Nguyen's just going to use that micro movement and going to the body. He's going to come back upstairs with this headshot. It's coming.
Martin punishing the legs early on, trying to chop down the legs of Kasabi, getting him stationary. Kasabi goes with the low kick.
Nguyen tenderizing that front leg to your point as Kasabi delivers a left to the belly.
Very patient is the situation as he takes out the leg, chopping down the limbs, and that support is not there on that left leg of Kasabi.
Ripping at the body of Nguyen.
Kasabi is a very elusive, footwork-influenced fighter. He loves to pull people in with the drawing of the head movement and the evasion, but right now he's not able to do that because that left leg is severely damaged. It looks like it's not severely damaged, but it's becoming compromised.
Yeah, it looks like he doesn't have the same spring on. He's really flat-footed on the front leg. That's limiting his movement. He lands one there.
You can see the swelling that's starting to develop on that lower left leg of Kasabi, as he still got power in those hands though.
Kasabi with the blue gloves. It's Nguyen ranked number 4 in the red gloves. Nguyen representing Vietnam and Australia. Kasabi representing Brazil. Again, chopping away at the front leg is Nguyen. Kasabi with a nice combination on the counterattack. Big left, Nguyen, 20 seconds, round one.
Man, when Nguyen lands, he's landing with bad intentions.
Peppering the jab there, Kasabi. 10 seconds to go in the first. Head kick, Kasabi.
Kasai's wearing the damage well.
Adorable. He's adorable, but he looks like he's got a little muscle for his age as well.
I know you called it a desperation shot, Rich, but I like the change of just giving Martin Nguyen something else to think about with the takedown attempt. I know he might not have been successful, but at least Nguyen is now thinking that a takedown could be coming from the Brazilian kickboxing champion.
It's early stages, round number two. Nguyen ranked number four in the featherweight division against Kasai.
Not a lot of heat behind those calf kicks, but they are touching up Kasai. And that's just gonna pay dividends as this match goes on.
Nice jab there from Kasai. Measuring the distance here on Nguyen.
Still not sure why Nguyen's corner didn't tell him to get his jab or something active just to put something in Kasai's face. Like you said, Kasai can give him something to think about, so too does Nguyen.
Nguyen just gave him something to think about by putting something in his face, and that was that right hand, Rich.
I just feel like he'd get it done quicker if he was throwing that left jab out there a few times.
Oh, 100%, but Nguyen don't need no jabs. When you got power in that right hand like that, flying knees like Nguyen can put on you, and that lead, that low leg kick is working like a jab. It's setting up that right hand. It's getting Kasai thinking about downstairs, and then Nguyen will come up top. Woo!
Nguyen at the body there, Kasai.
Nguyen threw two of those shovel hooks right there, and that was giving Kasai something to think about.
Kasai willing to stand in a trade, though. I'm impressed by this young man so far.
Nguyen's going with the jabs, but they're to the body of Kasai. That's like the third or fourth jab, fifth jab that he's thrown to the body of Kasai.
Jab the face that time of Kasai. And another one. Snapping the head back of Leonardo Kasai.
One thing that we should note here is off of all of Nguyen's combinations right there. Good head slip there. When he threw that right to the body and just threw that overhand right there, like he's getting his head offline. He's not there really to be hit by Kasai on the counter.
Yeah, Kasai's gonna have to make some adjustments with those counter punches because Martin Nguyen is dipping his head so far off to the side. If Kasai starts throwing high roundhouse kicks, he might be able to connect off those slips that Nguyen's doing.
Hook to the body from Nguyen, then the calf kick and a couple of more.
Now you can see the welt starting to develop on that lead leg of Kasai from those low leg kicks.
Nice left from Kasai on the way in.
Kasai needs to do a better job of cutting off this ring. Because
so he wasn't bothered by this last-minute opponent change. Martin Nguyen has been preparing for several different opponents over the course of his training camp, or at least this week, right, Rich? So both these guys experienced some adversity as Martin Nguyen lands a nice little right hand.
And he quarter turned out right there and just came back with that hook.
But coming out of the stoppage, you like Kasai there, the spinning back fist and then the head kick. And going up top with a kick again.
He's starting to mix things up now, and this is the kind of strategy he needs to get Nguyen thinking, at least.
Stiff jab from Nguyen, 144 in round two.
Piece pops out, Kasai's on the retreat. Martin Nguyen hunting.
Nguyen the overhand right. Right, he's cut off the angle, he's got his man in the corner. Now coming out of the corner is Kasai.
Dean's waiting for an opportunity to stop this action and pop that mouthpiece back in. Kasai gets protected.
Kasai pretty pleased with what he's shown so far with 80 seconds to go in the second.
This is the top shelf of the featherweight division he's in there against, and he's proven that he belongs with the upper echelon of this division. Showcasing toughness, weathered some adversity, got clipped a couple of times and is still in there.
And got clipped a couple of times against Martin Nguyen. Like, that's not just any fighter that's standing in front of him.
Yeah, Martin Nguyen has a highlight reel of right hand KOs that every fighter dreams about having, myself included. And that flying knee knockout against Jadambaa was a thing of beauty. So this guy is a highlight reel KO artist. And Kasai's in there getting it done against one of the best. Oh, spinning back fist. Martin Nguyen says that was good.
Yeah, that's two of them now in this round from Kasai.
Kasai's made some adjustments here with his head work. He slipped a few punches and it made Martin miss. I like what he's doing in the last minute.
Trading leather here inside the ring in Bangkok. 15 seconds. Entertaining stuff. Trading hooks now.
Nice little touch for Kasai on Nguyen's chin.
Snap Nguyen's head back that time with 5 seconds in the second body kick Nguyen, and that's it.
Seeing his athlete shoot some double legs, which Martin Nguyen has a good takedown.
Yeah, I think Martin's a much more complete fighter than he showed in this particular match tonight. Typically does a really good job with the jab. Like you said this earlier, Mitch, he's got a beautiful jab. Throws that shovel hook to the lead body. We haven't seen a ton of that tonight. And, you know, obviously the leg kicks has done a great job. You're looking at Kasadi's calf. But we haven't seen one takedown attempt by Martin. Great slip kick from him, but he's so many more tools that he just hasn't shown in this particular match.
Yeah, this fight, he really wants to show off that low leg kick and that big right hand. I wonder if he's surprised that Kasadi's still in there. He seems to be having a problem with his face. He keeps wiping his eyes.
4 minutes to go in the fight. Fourth-ranked Nguyen against Kasadi. Kasadi's spinning back kick. Cuffed ahead that time of Nguyen.
He's throwing some tricks in his bag as Martin Nguyen continues to beat on that leg. I am surprised that Kasadi is still moving forward the way that he is, because Martin Nguyen has touched that in the double digits.
Kasadi's moving forward right now, but he probably will not be tomorrow.
Good thing it's a short plane ride back to Phuket for him.
3:20 to go. Kasadi standing in, trying to cut off the angles here.
Rich, give us an unofficial scorecard. How do you have this one going down?
Oh, man, you're calling me out in the middle of the round. I'll tell you what, give me a second to think about this one.
Hold your feet to the fire. What do you think, Mitch?
I think he has shown a little bit more superior striking. He's showing the aggression. He's walking down Kasadi, engaging in the fight, forcing the action. And he's also landed some significant shots, especially to that lower leg. It might not be the biggest, most impactful shots, but they are scoring. And that seems to be giving, at least in my eyes, him the advantage.
Spin fist there, Kasadi.
Well, keep in mind that those leg kicks, I mean, you can see the actual damage, which is one of our scoring categories. But also note, like, in that first round, Nguyen wobbled Kasadi, which is what caused Kasadi to take that shot, which is an internal damage as well. So both those things are going to score on the scorecard, which is our second highest scoring category.
I know Rich don't like to be wrong, and he's been wrong so many times tonight, Brent, that he's afraid to put himself out there. Me, on the other hand, no, I'll make the call. I'll go against the grain. And there's that takedown that Amran Sam was asking for. And that's a huge scoring opportunity right there for Martin Nguyen.
With 2 minutes to go in the fight, he gets Kasadi to the canvas.
Beautiful job by Martin Nguyen to end up in the half guard of Kasadi. Let's see if Martin Nguyen can get past this half guard. He's got the pressure down with his right leg on the leg of Kasadi as he tries to slide his knee out. Kasadi's doing a good job of maintaining the guard so far, but Nguyen is aggressively trying to pass. He's trying to get that knee clear of the leg. This is a good spot as he's driving the shoulder right into the chin of Leonardo Kasadi.
Yeah, you can see that Nguyen right there was starting to look for the Kimura and then use that to regain the underhook on that side of the body there.
75 seconds remaining, third and final round. Again, the bout judged as a whole here in one championship.
Nguyen's trying to get that leg out of the half guard. You can see Kasadi's trying to utilize a lockdown just to trap that leg in position, but Nguyen now pushing on the leg to try to clear his leg. Now the knee's past the leg. Let's see if he can get that foot out. Might choose to go to the other side, but might just sit here and do work for the last 40 seconds.
A couple of short lefts there from Nguyen in tight quarters on the canvas. 35 seconds remaining.
This is a big win for Martin Nguyen if he's able to get it here today. He's had a lot of tough times, and you know, as Rich was talking about on the walk, he's went through a lot to get to this point and to get a big win.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure this takedown and maintaining this dominant position here has sealed the victory for him at this point in time. You talked about the damage he was on the cap earlier. We talked about the side of it. Now Nguyen's just starting to open things up. There's inside the 10-second call here, though, so Kasadi will survive this out.
Huge elbow.